Hi student, this is a clip for the laboratory tool, the Poisson ratio of rubbers. The learning objective of this lab is to let you to understand the mechanical behavior and the property of the rubber, including the stress strain relationship, the Poisson ratio, and the modulus of elasticity. The second one is to be able to use the measurement devices such as veneer, caliper, and the third, to be able to plan the testing appropriately. By doing this lab, the agile will provide you with the rubber band and will let you to decide the weight that you're going to put into the rubber band and the weight going to produce the stress. Okay, and also due to the rubber can elongate easily, so you also can compute the strain. And then you will plot the stress strain diagram. And by the stress strain diagram, you can compute the modulus of elasticity. And also by compute the strain in the lateral direction and strain in the longitudinal direction, you can compute the Poisson ratio. Okay, and the lab going to have some basic theory like this. Since the rubber is the deformed bevel body and it can deform a lot, so it's a good example to use in this lab. When you apply the force into the rubber band, the rubber band will elongate like this. It's elongate due to what? It's elongate due to the force that produces the stress inside it. And by doing this, you can compute the stress equal to the force divided by the area. And also the elongation that occurs there, it divides by the original length, you will get the average strain. By increase the force continuously, you will get the stress and strain continuously also, and then you can plot the stress strain diagram. Okay, and mostly at the rubber has the linear elastic behavior. When you pull it, it's going to elongate. When you release the force, it's come back to the original length. That means it is elastic. Okay, and when you put the stress and strain into the Hooke's law, the green is the Hooke's law, you will get the equation to compute the elongation of the rubber band in the linear elastic length easily. The Poisson ratio. Poisson have found that in the elastic region, the ratio of the lateral strain to the axial strain is a constant value. For the steel, is about 0.3. For the log, is about 0.1. Log of concrete is similar. And for the rubber band, is about 0.4. But less than 0.5. When you pull the lot, this one is the lot will elongate, and at the same time, it's going to contract in the lateral direction. So the lateral strain is minus due to its contraction, and minus of the delta part. The contaction value divided by the diameter. And the longitudinal strain is the total elongation divided by its original length. When you divide the lateral strain to the axial strain with the minus, it's going to be the Poisson ratio. In the contraction, things are just in the opposite direction. Poisson always positive because of the negative value in front of it. What do we need to use in this lab? You're going to use to have rubber band. John will provide you this. The veneer caliper. The micrometer, we will not use this because it is not good. It's too much detail. The ruler and the Poisson ratio testing apparatus and the weight. Okay. The step. Ajahn will give you the distance that will set as the reference. And then you're going to measure the width, the thickness. And then you can compute the width and the thickness, compute the area of the specimen. The area we use to calculate the stress. And you measure the length, okay, the total length. This is going to be used to calculate the longitudinal strain. And the width we use to compute the lateral strain. And then you got to plan the weight that you should put into the rubber band. It's maybe in between of 20 to 120 Newton. I recommend you start by 50 Newton. And the total step are 5. And then you do the same thing. You put the weight. You measure the width. And you also measure the length. And then you calculate the average value. The new length will minus the original length. You get the elongation. The elongation divided by the original length, you get the longitudinal strain. The new width minus the original width, you get the contraction. And then you divide the original width, you get the lateral strain. You put the values, the lateral strain and longitudinal strain into the Poisson ratio equation. You got the Poisson ratio for each load step. You also divide the weight with the original area. You got the stress. So if you do it 5 times, you're going to get 5 stress strain points for stress strain diagram. And you also get the 5 Poisson ratio. You average the 5 Poisson ratio. You get the average value of Poisson ratio. And for the stress strain diagram, you measure the slope, you get the modulus of elasticity of the rubber band. Okay, the testing result will be like this. So at the start, the weight is 0. You measure the length, you measure on the left and on the right of the mark. And then you measure the width, the top, the middle, and the bottom. And also you measure the thickness, the top, the middle, and the bottom. And you do the average, everything. And then you increase the weight, for example, 10 Newton. You measure the new length, okay, it's going to be 60.3. And then you measure the width, again, 3 times, get the average. And then you, this time you may not need to measure the thickness, it's okay. Then the stress. The stress is going to be the weight, 10 Newton, divided by the area, the width times the thickness. You get the stress. And for the elongation, you put 60.3 minus 60 and divided by 60, you get this value. For the lateral strain, you may put this one minus this one. That's going to be negative. And then divided by 49.81, you get this. And then you may put this one and divide it by longitudinal strain to the Poisson ratio equation, you get it 0.44. Okay, and you do this the same as before, you will get all the value we have. You put the stress with the longitudinal strain, you get strain diagram, and you average all the Poisson ratio, you get the average Poisson ratio. Okay, and that's mean what do we have is the normal stress. What do you mean by this? Normal strain, you compute this, compute lateral and longitudinal strain, and then you draw stress strain diagram, you compute the Poisson ratio, and you find the elastic modulus. Do wide discussion and compare testing result with the reference, the standard that we can search from the library and make some conclusion on this. Okay, this is the detail of the laboratory tool. And then you may watch the clips to make you more understand on this. And I will provide you with the detail of other thing. If you get some question, just ask me and the TA. Okay, bye bye.